everyone. Thank you for watching our webinar related to access management for secure and simplified information sharing. Today we would like to discuss goals and benefits we were thinking about when introducing new access management. About access management itself and its architecture, we will mention deprecation status for authorization models, as well as how you can migrate to access management, what you can expect from access management in a ZL3DON size 9.5 release, and of course with the demo at the end. More and more applications and services allow you to authenticate via shared identity providers like LinkedIn, Google, Microsoft Office, and etc. So looking on the effort to implement this in 3DON sites, it's enormous. It's not only a problem for us as R&D, it's also a problem for a customer. They need to configure each application for a particular identity provider. Sometimes businesses might want to add some user, possibly a freelancer, and provisioning an enterprise account. It's also a challenge. Ideally, if this control is with the business to provide certain user access for a temporary amount of time, then revoke it without involving IT would be an advantage. 3DON sites has quite large list of applications and services now. So like add-on service is a separate service. On content manager side, you have content manager explorer, experience manager, core service, topology manager, some Windows forms applications like content porter, template builder, visual flow designer, and as well various services on content delivery side. All of them have their own authentication mechanism. And even looking on content manager side, they are different. For example, SAML is only supported in UI interfaces like Content Manager Explorer and Experience Manager. And the reason for this is that if you want to add another provider to this list, we need to implement support for it in each and every application and service. Additionally, Dynamic Experience Delivery currently uses an internal token service to provide authentication, which is not hooked up to any enterprise identity management system. And managing those identity across a scale-out environment is difficult, as the identities are stored in the local file. And the solution for this is to have a separate module that will be like a federated gateway. It's called access management. Instead of configuring identity provider in each and every application and service, we will do it only via access management. And then sites, dynamic experience delivery in the future, and docs as well, so in the future, the application and services will talk to access management only. So in access management, you can configure different identity providers like Azure ID, Google ID, and each of them can have its own protocol, like OpenID Connect, SAML, Windows Auth. And our applications and services will talk to access management only via OpenID Connect. It's important to mention why we have chosen OpenID Connect protocol. Because SAML 2P setting up it is difficult due to B-party trust using certificates. For Windows, this locks customer to use only Active Directory. As fold up, it's under the hood uses basic authentication. And as you can see, it's also valid to mention that for customers that do not want, so if they want to use internet only setup, they can set up a local ADFS and to do not use any cloud identity provider. So on this architecture diagram, access management is a federated gateway to identity providers and a token service for authentication from service to service for client ID, client secret authentication. As already said, in access management, we are centralizing our configuration, so configured once, it can be used by all applications and services. Let's look on the benefits that our customers will have out of the access management. So access management enables single sign-on across all applications. You need to configure only single application on external system, and internal applications are pre-configured on the gateway. We need to support only OpenID protocol across our applications and services. Authentication for application is not impacted by external identity provider changes. And identity providers can change their settings over the time, and we are safe with this. And additionally, adding new protocol is a matter to implement it in a single place, only in access management. Looking at authentication flow, we are following OpenID Connect rules for this. Initial release of access management in terms of sites 9.5 will support following identity providers, so SAML 2.0, OpenID Connect, Windows, and NotApp. In sites 9.5, access management will be used by add-on service itself and add-on clients for service-to-service communication. Both Tridion sites UI, Classic and Experience Space. And this is, here is valid to mention that by logged in once to either Classic, CME or New Experience Space, you won't need to re-log in to another one. And it also will be supported by new core service REST, although it's not public in 9.5 release. Starting from sites 9.5, I would like to mention that access management is our default authorization mechanism for Tridion DX. And old authorization models are deprecated, but here I mean configuration via configuration files per content management instance, so like LDAP, SAML, SSO was already deprecated, and it's also valid to mention that LDAP is not recommended to use. The reason is that LDAP is sent login password in open form. And new or recently introduced in release services support only authorization via access management. So it's add-on service, experience space, and new core service REST. Let's talk how you can migrate to use new access management. As the first step, what you need to do is to set up your access management. The next step is creating and configuring your first identity provider. Set, then you need setup for forwarding claims for identity provider groups to be able to map external identity provider groups to Tridion sites groups. Next step is performing general upgrade, so database upgrade and product upgrade via sudo installer. As part of the upgrading with sudo installer, you will have possibility to enable access management right away by just providing endpoint for the service. In case you would like to migrate to access management later, you might skip enabling access management right away during upgrade, and you can enable it later by running migration script. So you will need to do it per each content manager environment in case you have a scale out scenario. Swagger definition will be our default public documentation and will be available as part of default service installation. Summarizing everything that was already mentioned, what you can expect from access management in Sites 9.5. So it will have a public REST API endpoint that can be used for automation. We support following identity provider types like SAML 2.0, OpenID Connect, Windows, and LDAP. Access management is integrated with add-on service and its clients, classic Tridion Sites UI, brand new Tridion Sites Experience Space, and core service REST that is not public in 9.5 release. It has HTTPS support, it supports Microsoft SQL Server and Oracle databases. It has audit trail to filter user actions over system. And for 9.5 release, it will be available via REST API only. And we respect GDPR, so you can disable, enable users, or even completely remove it from the system. It's demo time. I would like to hand over to Natalia to do a demo related to access management.
Thanks, Andrey. Let me share my screen. I will demonstrate how to create and configure identity provider in access management. So basically, you can open access management from CME. There is a link to it, or just navigate directly. I do have already one identity provider configured, and now I will just want to add another one. As an example, I will use O0 identity provider. Just before configuring this identity provider in access management, so you first need to register access management application in O0. I have already done this, and now I can proceed with basically configuring it in access management. When you click to add your identity provider, you will see this wizard and you start filling all the necessary fields. So first it's a key, it's a unique identifier of the identity provider, name. Here you need to select what type of identity provider. So I will use OpenID Connect. Now you need to provide more information about your external identity provider. Basically, all this information you can get once you register access management application in your IDP. So I already registered, so I have all this information up front. I'll just go and authority. Not all fields are mandatory, so there are also optional fields. It really depends on the identity provider. And session. And here are two more mandatory fields, username claim and full name claim. So basically it's a claim from your external IDP that will be used to create users in access management. So I will use claim name as a username, and the email, it's gonna be my username, and name claim as a full name claim. And you go to the next screen. Here you provide forwarded claims. What does it mean? Access management does not forward any claims from the external identity provider. If you want to forward these claims, you need to set it here. So what it means, basically, access management will forward these claims through the Tridion applications. For example, the use case here is, for example, if you want to use claim for the group mapping in CME. So you can then create this claim. The next screen is access settings. And here you create a mapping between external claims and the application and roles in Tridion. So you can provide a specific claim and value, or you can give global access, which means all users, doesn't matter what claims external IDP will expose, all users from this IDP will have will use global application and roles that you set up here. So I will just create administrator user. So I'm giving all the access to the application, and then you need to select roles. So I'm giving administrator roles. And here you click save. So your IDP is created. When IDP is created, it generates some redirect URLs. Basically, it's a redirect URL that you need to specify for the access management application registration in an external IDP. Once you create it, you can validate if you created this IDP properly. And you will get a page. So if you're getting this page, then access management can successfully connect to the external IDP. On this page, you can also see what kind of claim types and values are exposed by this IDP. So basically now you can try to log in to CME or to the Content Manager Explorer with this IDP. You will get login screen. So that was my first IDP, and I was here at something that I just added. So now you have two options to login. You can use the So basically, you can just add new IDP and start using it to log into Tridion applications. So what else you have in access management? Once you log in as a user, access management creates automatically all the users. So you can see all the users on the users tab, And also, if you want to disable access for that user, you can just go open the user and disable the user and or enable back. So when you disable, a user will not have access, will not be able to log into Tridion applications. So I'll hold. I think that was it for my demo.
Thank you, Natalia. Maybe it makes sense also to show briefly service accounts to communicate from service to service.
Yes, true. So in access management, we do have service accounts. So what is this service account mean? It's basically accounts that you can use if you want to use API directly. We do have already pre-configured service accounts. For example, if I want to use, if I want to communicate to add-ons API. So basically, I can use the service account, and I can use the service account has a client ID, and you can also generate a client secret for it. Basically, this client ID and client secret you can use to get a token from Access Management, and then use that token to make requests to the add-on service.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Natalia, for a great presentation. So let me share my screen. Thank you, everyone, for watching our webinar related to access management. And see you on the next webinar. Thank you.